Last month, students affiliated with Black Lives Matter at William & Mary shut down an event where a member of the ACLU of Virginia was scheduled to speak. The students shut it down for ACLU's role in defending the free speech rights of some of the alt-right white supremacist marchers in Charlottesville in August. The protesters shouted, "ACLU, you protect Hitler too. The revolution will not uphold the Constitution. And liberalism is white supremacy." Presumably, the goal of the protest was to prevent certain topics or arguments from being presented, and they were, of course, successful in that. And you, of course, have a book that I'm sure addresses much of this, Hate, Why We Should Resist It with Free Speech, Not Censorship. In your research, have you found that sometimes these efforts to silence ideological opponents work? And what do you think they're trying to accomplish?
Well, it was ironically, the executive director of the ACLU of Virginia was going to be speaking on campus about free speech rights on campus. And
she even said, "I like this," yes, when the protesters started.
Yeah. And so the students very proudly videotaped their breaking of the law. They're violating her free speech rights and the audience free speech rights and the campus regulations. And actually, they boasted, "We shut down a campus program," which is very, very sad. I put myself in her position because, as you forecast, my book is going to be punished, I'm sure. And I was wondering, what is the most constructive way as a teacher, as somebody who definitely wants to empathize with them? And I dislike their ideas, but I tolerate them, right? So I don't want to demonize and disparage these protesters the way I think too often happens. So what's positive about what they're doing? Well, they are passionately committed to social justice and racial justice. So I want to thank them for that, but I would love to have the opportunity to persuade them that freedom of speech, especially for the thought that we hate, is their most essential ally. And censorship, more precisely, giving the power of censorship to university officials or government officials, is the most counterproductive strategy to advancing any law reform cause, including racial justice and social justice. And all we have to do is look at history. The history of tolerating limits on hateful or hated speech was the history that censored in this country abolitionists and civil rights activists. I mean, why did Martin Luther King write his historic letter from a Birmingham jail? Because his speech was considered hate speech and hateful speech. And the same has been true for the LGBT rights movement, the women's rights movement, the movement for reproductive freedom.